stage magic, okay? There's close-up magic. There's something called parlor magic, which, you know, it's kind of in the middle. But I just found out about a new type of magic. These are the unsung heroes of magic. They're called card mechanics. Now, the reason why they're unsung heroes is they don't do it for the applause or the assistance or whatever. No, these are the guys that show up at the local card room with one intention, to swindle you for every dollar you have. Now, not only are they not doing it for the applause, if they screw up, they get killed. So, before the show started, I asked if somebody had any gambling experience. Junior! Let's give Junior a big round of applause because he makes his way to the stage. Come on up here, man. Stand right over here for me, Junior. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to give you a bird's eye view of what we're going to do is I'm going to show you what a card mechanic does, okay? Let's just pretend for a moment none of these people here look like I'm just shuffling the cards. You know, it might even look like that. It may even seem like Junior here is going to cut the deck. Junior, go ahead and take a cut. Just once, yeah, the other half goes on top. And Junior, have we ever met before? No. But for some reason, you put all those cards in the order I wanted you to. Nicely done. It's okay to applaud at this point. You see, I said it's not very flashy, but it is very fun. Because what I'm going to do is if we are at a card table, Junior, not even knowing it, is actually in on the gag. He's going to help me. Go ahead and cut him one more time for me. Yeah, Heather, look at you go, see? And for some reason, he just put them right back in order again. I don't know how this is happening, except for the fact you rock. Thank you very much. All right. Now, that's using an entire deck of cards. We're going to break it down a little bit. We're only going to use three. You see, Junior, before Blackjack, there was a game called the Three-Card Monty. It went all over America, and it's still actually being played today. We're going to use three cards, a three of clubs, an ace of hearts, and a two of clubs. That's one, two, and three. The name of the game. Easy, Junior. All I need you to do is keep your eye on the red card. Junior, is that clear? We're going to begin by placing the red card right there on the left-hand side, with one black card in the middle and one black card on the right. Junior, are you ready? Here comes the movie. Pay attention. Point to where you think the red card might be. Right there on the left. Way to go, Captain Obvious. You would have said the right-hand side. You wouldn't have done that well, because it's right there in the middle. A traditional applause cue point at this time. All right. We're going to make an audience out of you yet. All right. So, Junior, we're going to make it even easier. Since the red card ended up in the middle, that's where it'll begin. And one black card on either side. Junior, are you ready? Here comes the move.
Yeah.
Points where you think the red card might be. Then take a stab on the right. Hey, at least you guessed, because if you would have done the middle, you wouldn't have done that good, because it's right there on the left-hand side. I give you props for guessing, because the last guy just picked one right for no apparent reason. Anyway, so we're going to get rid of one of the three cards, leaving us with only two cards. A red one and a black one. Junior, are you ready? There comes the moon. That was the moon. Point to where you think the red card might be. Good boy. Ladies and gentlemen, let's hear it. Appreciate this, but one day he's gonna look back and he's gonna thank his Uncle Nicky. Because the next thing he's going to need is a beautiful assistant. And Zion, I'd like you to meet my assistant. Say hello to the beautiful Cassie.
I love you.
No one's going to notice. Okay. The third thing you're going to need is a loud and cheering audience. Let's do this.